There we go. I think we're all set now. So, you are welcome to this online worship for March the 20th, 2022. Can you imagine March the 20th already? It's for St. Paul's Presbyterian Church in Burlington, Ontario. And we thank you for joining by Zoom or when you later by YouTube. And this is the second of our 200th anniversary events. And we will look at a sample of the music which has been used in worship in the heritage of the past 200 years. You may find it interesting that some of the popular hymns today are many centuries old. The words speak across the generations. But first of all, some of our announcements. We're in the season of Lent and a special time in the liturgical year, a time of preparing to understand the meaning of Easter in a deeper way than what we had before. As we surrender into a relationship with Jesus, we're able to praise more fully. The session will meet this week to discuss the reopening plans. And if all is well, then we will reopen next Sunday for in-person worship. But we will still continue to post the recording on YouTube for those who are unable to attend. The men's ministry meets at Wednesdays at 9:30 a.m. in person in the sanctuary or via Zoom. And you can contact me if you want the Zoom link at stpaulsburlington@gmail.com. You can save the date for next Saturday when the men's virtual talk, it will be at 9:30 a.m. and we'll have at 9 a.m. a chance for a meet and greet. Reverend Rob Elka of Evangel Tabernacle in Dresden, Ontario, will be presenting on the end times. It's the book of Revelation. His goal is to clear up those cobwebs and give an overview of the basic structure of these events and how we might fit into this picture. His topic is what lies ahead. Ladies and gents are all welcome. Our session meeting will be at 3 p.m. via Zoom on this Wednesday, March 23rd. You'll be getting that link very soon, elders. The Jean Gordon Auxiliary will be meeting Thursday, April the 7th at 1 p.m. and all the ladies are welcome for that. And I think they'll be meeting in the sanctuary. The Lenten book study has started, and this Wednesday will be our third session. And please notice the time change from 2 o'clock to 1:30 p.m. It's so we can have a bit of time to transition into our session meeting at 3. And this study is based on Matt Sorcato's book 3:16, which the numbers of hope, and it's basically looking at the verses in John 3:16 and around it. The World Day of Prayer, if you can look in your announce mail, you will see ways in which you can participate. We're not doing it as a group of churches in the Burlington area, but each congregation or each individual person would be doing it separate. So with the crisis in Ukraine, we know that it's getting worse and worse, and the amount of refugees are climbing higher and higher. They are certainly in need of our prayers, but they also need our support because there is a humanitarian crisis. And many things are needed for the refugees, and there are many things needed for those in Ukraine. The Presbyterian Church in Canada, through its aid agency, Presbyterian World Service and Development, PWS&D, is working along with our traditional partners, ACT Alliance and the Canadian Food Grains Bank, to help provide aid in Eastern Europe. If you'd like to make a donation to this effort, there are a few ways. Give directly to the www.werespond.ca/Ukraine-crisis or give through our church to PWS&D. And if it is through our church, please clearly indicate that it is for the Ukraine crisis on your donation. It will be included in your income tax receipt at the end of the year. gifts to PWS&D are different from your Presbyterian sharing donations. Those are two separate. Although the Presbyterian sharing donations do support PWS&D in covering the administration costs for them, which means that all of your gifts to the Ukraine crisis go fully to that cause. But please continue to pray. Well, that thing which engages us, inspires us, connects us, empowers us, soothes us, and fills our spirits to the very brim, music lies within us and surrounds us in our everyday culture. The songs of the earth echo in our souls. We carry them in our hearts. In this way, music becomes a part of us. It's a form of expression, a language that knows no bounds. When our words fail, praise and music speaks. We cannot keep silent, so we sing. We sing about faith and love and experiences. We sing about spring and the change in seasons. We sing about singing. How can we not? With thousands of hymns and songs to choose from, I decided to take a different approach than trying to pick some favorites. We probably need many weeks to do them. But I chose hymns and songs from the various books used over the 200 years, along with some YouTube and some recorded music. Well, if you look on this page, you'll see some of the books that I've taken songs from today. The Psalter from 1650, the Book of Praise from 1918, Songs of Praise for Schools. I'm not sure whether they use these in Ontario, but they were used in Montreal. And there was three different ones, elementary, public, and high school. And but they are printed in Toronto, so they may have been used here as well. And then the 1972 Book of Praise, the book Praiseways that came out in 1975, and then the current Book of Praise from 1996. So to give a sample of what our congregation used in 1822, this describes the Scottish Psalter of 1650. This version, after repeated revisals, was approved by the Westminster Assembly, and having undergone further careful revision by members of the General Assembly of the Church of Scotland, it was adopted and sanctioned in 1649, and on the 15th day of May in the following year, that's 1650, was for the first time used publicly in Glasgow. It claims to be more plain, smooth, and agreeable to the text than any versions heretofore. And though many attempts have been made to supersede it, yet none have been successful. The firmness with which it was held its place being undoubtedly owing to its real excellence, its intrinsic merits, as well as to endearing associations with which it has come to be surrounded. That quote was from Andrew Duncan, and it was written 232 years after the publishing, so in 1882. The Scottish Psalter continued to be used along with other hymnals until later in the early 1900s, when it was incorporated into the Presbyterian hymnals of the day. In fact, in the opening words of the 1918 Book of Praise, it says 134 songs from the 1650 Psalter were used. Well, we have 10 selections today, so I hope your voice is well warmed up. It will be by the end. And our first one is As Pants the Heart. It was first written in the 1700s, and it's based on Psalm 42. And it would probably have been sung a cappella when St. Paul's first started as a congregation. So the words are by N. Tate and N. Brady, music by H. Wilson. The copyright is public domain, and our streaming CCL license is 2829867. So would you please sing along As Pants the Heart. I am sorry, but it worked half an hour ago, and I don't know why it's not working now. Just a second. Okay. Well, looks like that song doesn't want to work for us today. So we'll come to the second song, which is Come Thou Font of Every Blessing. And it was first used in the 1918 Book of Praise, but it was not continued into the 1972 or the 1996 versions. But it's still sung today. And I have a story about the origin of this popular hymn. And I would just like to read that for you first.
I'll put the recording back on.
Oh, it went off?
The YouTube recording.
That's what I thought it was still working. Just a second. Emily says it's showing on hers, so.
Okay.
Oh, yes, it's still recording. I see it. Okay. So this was written by Robert Robinson, and he lived between 1735 and 1790. When Robert Robinson was a very young boy, his father died. And at the age of 14, Robert went to London to work for a hairdresser. While there, he fell among evil companions. One Sunday in 1752, they brought some liquor to an old woman who told fortunes. So as to enjoy a good laugh as they listened to her prophecies, when she told Robinson, however, that he would live to see his children and grandchildren, the prophecy sobered him with the thought of responsibilities of life. Shortly afterwards, he heard George Whitefield preach on the wrath to come and fell under deep conviction, which continued for 3 years. At length, at the age of 20, hearing the preaching of Wesley, he came to the fount of every blessing with prayer. Here's my heart, I'll take and seal it. And soon afterward, he entered the ministry, beginning his work in the chapel of Mindenhall in Suffolk. 2 years later, in 1757, while pastor in Norwich, the memory of his conversion brought to his soul a new joy of that experience. And under the influence of that memory, he wrote the lines of gratefulness to God. Come thou font of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy praise. It was published in the following year in Norfolk. So that's a bit of the history of this hymn that we sing. So let's come with the words by Robert Robinson from 1758. The melody, Nettleton, was by John Wythe, and it's public domain, and there's our streaming license. So let's sing along.
Yeah.
our call to worship, would you please respond with the darker print? O Lord, open our lips. It is good to praise the Lord and make music to your name, O Most High. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. And this is taken from Psalm 92, verse 1 and 2, and 95, 1 and 2, which is the book of songs from the Hebrew worship. I didn't say psalms, I said songs. So it's each of the 150 songs in the book of Psalms is used for worship in various ways. Let us pray. Holy and creative God, we acknowledge that creation sings the Father's song. You call the sun to wake the dawn and run the course of day, till evening falls in crimson rays. Hallelujah, let all creation stand and sing. Hallelujah. Let us fill the earth with songs of worship and tell the wonders of creation's King. Amen. And that prayer was adapted from Keith and Tristan Getty's song, Creation Sings the Father's Song. And our scripture today is Psalm 150. So please listen. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thanks be to God for this, his word. So the next song is from O God, Our Help in Ages Past, and its words were from Isaac Watts and music William Croft, and again, this is public domain. Oh, it looks like the YouTube videos aren't working for some reason. I'm just going to see if I can. Okay, let's see if this works now. Let's move on to the next one. I'm sorry about that. I tried it, like I said, about a half hour ago, and everything worked fine. So the next one is from the Song of Praise for School, and this is the introduction to the song Stand Up for Jesus. When the Reverend Dudley Tyne, a Philadelphia cleric, lay dying as a result of an accident, he sent a final message to his parishioners saying, "Tell them to stand up for Jesus." Reverend George Duffield, using his words, wrote this beloved hymn, which he read at the close of his memorial sermon. His sermon text was Ephesians 6, verse 14, and the tune is by George Webb, an American composer. So I hope that this one will work. Let's see. So words by George Duffield, music by George James Webb, and it is public domain. No. And so it looks like none of the YouTube songs are going to work.
Bob, there's a thing on my screen that says security warning. References to external media objects have been blocked. But then on the right side, it says enable content. I wonder if that's what's up.
Okay. I didn't see that on mine.
Oh, so yeah, it's right at the top.
Okay, I see there that. There it is. Yeah. Okay, well, let's see if that will work. Oh. Yep, now it's working. Good. Thanks, Chris. So we'll go right into the next one. Stand up for Jesus.
Thank you.
our next song is taken from Praise Ways. And I just said that came out in 1975. This book was often used with children, perhaps in a vacation Bible school. But I know we have sung this in worship as well. And it's He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. And the words and music are anonymous. And it's a public domain. And so let's sing along with this one. Our next song is Fair as Lord Jesus. It was first used in the 1972 Book of Praise, but I suspect it was used in worship earlier than that. So the words are anonymous. It's a Silesian folk song, and again, public domain. And here's our streaming license. So let's sing along.
Of God and Mary, the
We come to our offering time, and please give an extra gift towards the anniversary. If you need any ideas, you can make it with the number 200 in it, $2, 20, 200, etc. And please indicate on your offering that it is for the anniversary fund. The for info on an anniversary or for regular offerings, you can contact Ron Dambo at 905-330-2909 or edambo@simpatico.ca. Our invitation to the offering is this: Lord, let our congregation be a witness to you, immersed in scripture, constant in prayer, joyful in worship, generous in giving, a loving, supportive community reaching out to those in need. Accept these gifts that we offer in Jesus' name. Amen. And our prayer of dedication is this: God of grace, it is our delight and our devotion to give these gifts to you. All we are and all we have are yours alone. Accept this joyful offering as a token of our abiding love. Use it to bring peace, justice, and comfort to all the world. Amen. So our next song is one that's been in the 1918, 1972, and the 1996 Books of Praise, and is written by Reverend Edward Perronet in the 1700s, but still has the power to change people today. So I would like to read you something. It's a book that I have. It's called 101 Hymn Stories. So Edward Perronet lived from 1726 to 1792. The Reverend Edward Perronet was a most devout man who had the courage of his convictions and was not afraid to suffer for what he thought to be right. He lived in the days of the Wesleys and was intimate with them, and the philanthropic Lady Huntington was his patroness for a time. But these friends he felt necessary to surrender because he conscientiously differed with them on some points of belief. His immortal hymn, "All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name," was proved a blessing to Protestants of all beliefs. One of the most dramatic instances of its use was found in the experience of the Reverend E.P. Scott in India. His friends had urged him not to venture near a certain barbarous inland tribe whom he wished to evangelize. But he went forward with high courage, never wavering in his duty and trusting in God to protect him. When at last he reached their country among the hills, he came upon a company of these savages. Immediately they surrounded him, pointing their spears at him with threatening scowls. He had nothing in his hands but his violin, and so closing his eyes, he began to play and sing, "All hail the power of Jesus' name." When last he opened his eyes, he expected to be killed instantly, but his life had been spared through the singing of the hymn. Their spears had dropped, and they received him first with curiosity and interest, and then later with eagerness, as he told them the gospel story and won their hearts to the will of Jesus Christ. This version is sung by Paul Balash, and it uses various instruments, not a violin, but other instruments. So please sing along.
Name, let angels prostrate
Well, this next song is a personal and favorite one of mine. It was new to the 1996 hymn book, but I first experienced it in 1985 when it was a piece of music that was instrumental in my call to believe in and to serve Jesus. I, the Lord of Sea and Sky, also known as Here I Am, Lord. Words and music by Daniel L. Schutt, and it's copyright New Dawn Music from 1981. And that's our streaming license. Please sing along.
I'm
Let us come in prayer. Lord Jesus, our praises rise to you. And we're so thankful that over these past 200 years, we have people who have wanted to praise you in the community of the church in various ways, whether it be through voice or whether it's by playing instruments or by singing along with the congregation, with choirs, with anthems, all these praises they have lifted up to you. And we still want to continue to do that in every way possible. We do thank you that throughout the ages that you have had people, that you've brought people who have the gifts and the talents to be able to lead in singing and in playing. We also give you the give thanks to you for the people who have written these words and these tunes. These ones from the 1600s and the 1700s are still powerful today because your spirit enlivens them for us. And they are truth for us. And it's so important to have this heritage of these truths moving forward in our praise of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. It is our praise that enables us to be able to be connected with you and so that we can intercede for others. And today our hearts are with the people of Ukraine, the people of the surrounding countries who are taking in refugees, those over 3 million refugees that have already left the country, for the thousands of soldiers who are dying in this conflict on all sides, families that are grieving the loss of their sons and daughters. So much pain, Lord, so much. But you can handle all this. You gather them into your care. And we are so grateful that we have a God who is personal with us and who loves us and who loves everyone in this world and who will gather us as a mother hen gathers her flock under her wings to protect them. Let us not be tempted into ways of looking negatively, but may we continue to surrender ourselves into our relationship with you, O Lord. So the people on our prayer wall, the people in our prayer mail, the people who we hold dear in our hearts, we continue to lift them to you. And Lord, we know and we need to be reminded from time to time that the prayer that is always answered is, thy will be done. And we pray that your will be done in this world, that there will be nothing that will hinder it. There will be nothing that will cause us to stumble in being obedient to it. And that in every way, we may continue to sing your praises for decades and decades to come. Lord, you are the object of our praise. Thank you for going to the cross of Calvary and paying the price of our disobedience, of our wrongdoings, of our little white lies, of our big lies, as of our ways that when we think that we're in control. You paid the price for all of that so that we would be able to gather into the presence of the Father and to be able to say, we praise our God, three in one, one in three. Thanks be to God. And now in the words that Jesus himself has taught us to pray, Let us say together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Well, the next song was first written in 2001, and it's considered to be a modern day hymn. In Christ Alone is a song that we have sung many times. Its words, although fairly new, have the same impact as our older songs, and I think they will have for many decades to come. Please, words and music by Keith Getty and Stuart Townsend, copyright 2001 Thank You Music, and our streaming license is 282-9867. Please sing along. While our closing song is a YouTube version that was born out of the opposition to war, it is particularly appropriate for what the world is facing now. So it's Riverside, and it's a YouTube featuring Grandpa Elliot in New Orleans. And it's for the Playing for a Change movement throughout the world. And so far, there's been 6.5 million views on YouTube. So here we go, and we're going to add to that one more time. Words by Peter D. Smith, copyright Stainer and Bell, and our streaming license is 282-9867. You'll probably be able to sing along with parts of it. You'll see some interesting things in it, and I hope that it raises your praise.
I'm gonna lay down my burden, down by the riverside, down by that river, down by that riverside, gonna lay down my burden, down by that riverside. Study war no more. I ain't gonna study war no more. Study war no more. Study war no more. No more. I ain't gonna study war no more. Study war no more. Study war no more. Down my sword and shield,
down by the riverside,
down by the riverside,
down by the riverside.
Don't lay down my sword and shield,
down by the riverside. Study war no more.
I ain't gonna study war no more.
Study war no more.
Study war no more.
No more.
I ain't gonna study war no more.
Study war no more.
May the peace of the Lord be with us all. I pray that this 200th anniversary service that looked at the heritage of music, showing how it has helped bolster the praise of Almighty God over these last 200 years, has been meaningful and praise-filled for each of you. When you are at loss for words, sing a song of praise. The reason why some of these older songs mean so much is because they focus us to the one God made known to us in the Father and in the Son and in the Holy Spirit. May we keep on singing for many, many decades to come. May the blessing of God, the giver of every good and perfect gift, and of Christ who summons us to service, and of the Holy Spirit who inspires generosity and love, be with us all. Amen, amen, and amen.